We had today, not only the snow, then we had plenty of sunshine by the afternoon.
Yeah, that's right. And then from that sun, it gave some boost to some of our showers, and now we've got downpours and some hail out there. So it's like everything's going crazy around here, going bonkers weather-wise. Outside tonight, a live look from our Coin Tower cam. Look off in the distance. See how dark the sky is? I mean, not just because it's getting dark, but those clouds that kind of hang a little low. Those are some of our heavy cells that are moving mainly across Clark County, but also North Portland tonight. Now, the temperature is 42 degrees, but I want to take you out to 3D pinpoint Doppler, and this band of showers stretches to about Highway 30, you know, in the St. John's area. And you see it doesn't pop off the screen too much here, but as we work our way across North Portland, this is the Maywood Park area and northeast up to Marine Drive. This thing really popping off the screen. It is dumping. It's mainly rain, but I'm getting some reports of hail in this area as well. And here's another one of these cells that was in Vancouver. Now it is mainly over Camas and Washougal and moving into the gorge. So these are the last of the showers, and boy, they are some good ones tonight. By the way, this morning, it wasn't hail in Clark County. Instead, it was the snow. Look at the overnight snow, our time lapse from our HD camera in Vancouver. So many places look just like this while we were sleeping. But when the sun came up, Vancouver and downtown, your official total was 1.5 inches of snow. Portland, where we measure it, near PDX, a third of an inch. So location made a big difference. By the way, here's the Sussman family snowman. It's the best we could muster out of 1 inch of snow. Yes, Amy's clapping. Thank you, Amy. I'll tell you, the snowman could have been a little bigger up at Mount Hood Meadows. Look at the tables there. 19 inches of snow in 24 hours. So there's some definite powder skiing going on up on the mountain. What about rain, though? You know, we've ended another month, right? We're into March. The rainy season so far, it starts in October, so we get all the rainy months grouped together. How are we doing? Portland, 92% of average. So I'd say we're just somewhat drier than a typical rainy season. That's not too bad. Salem, you're 96% of average, so I'd put you in the right on the money category. And Astoria, and those of you along the coast, you've had the best winter compared with normal, at least if you like drier weather, 81% of average, so much drier than what we typically see along our coastline. And those of you along the coast, I know you've had a great winter, relatively speaking. 45 today in Portland, 46 in Newport, and 40s east of the Cascades. Right now, already some 30s. Vancouver, the showers have cooled you to 39, and West Lynn, 38 degrees. So it's a chilly, kind of raw night out there. Salem, you'll be in the 30s in the next little bit, give it another hour or so. A weak system is coming in from the north. It arrives during the day tomorrow once we've warmed up. So it's a rainmaker, not a snowmaker. Now, tonight at 9, still showing a few showers in the area where we have the showers going right now, but then we're dry after that. Tomorrow morning, dry for the commute. Watch for patchy fog and frost right here in the Willamette Valley. By midday and into tomorrow night at this time, an increasing chance of rain. It does look like a wet Friday evening commute. All right, lows. Cold and below freezing east of the mountains, right near the freezing mark in the Willamette Valley. Highs tomorrow will be in the 40s, both along the coast where we'll have some light rain at times, and in the Willamette Valley we'll also see 40s after that patchy fog and frost will warm up and bring in some light rain later on towards evening commute time if you're in Salem or Corvallis. Partly sunny and cool for central and eastern Oregon. A chilly start and highs never get out of the 40s. And up in the Cascades, well, we'll have some afternoon or evening snow developing right at the passes and rain below that. So, Sandy, you'll get some rain instead of snow tomorrow night. All right, Cascade locks in the 40s tomorrow and just wet weather through the gorge. So patchy fog and frost out the door in the morning, the increasing chance of rain as we go through the day. The weekend, looking pretty decent. Saturday, we have some showers around, that's true, but Sunday looks dry and near 60 degrees, and we may do that again on Monday. This is what we call paybacks for the cold and the snow and the hail, everything that's been happening in the last 48 hours.
We're holding on to Sunday.
There we go.
Okay, Bruce.